everybody. Dave Monyhan here, Guts and Tools and Supplies, and time for once again another Tech Lab Tuesday. Yeah, I'm still going to give you some more insight on our 3D fast cut systems. As you know, we just talked about our bringing back the MGA MIC, which is a must have a tool for any shop, setting up 3D dimensions for counterboring and some of the other things I talked about. But I want to go into a little more detail on the 3D fast cut system itself. This is the standard kit right here. It comes with a ball head, comes with three tool tip holders, comes with four cutter tips, the wrenches, the bounce springs, the bushings, and the tool setting device. That's your start right there to get into the standard Chevy, Ford, and quite a few applications, whether it's diesel or gas. The tool allows you to cut the three angles simultaneously with a single carbide blade. That's the beauty of that within the range. You got a range of a little over an inch to just over 2 inches in the standard kit. Now, to that result, we also make a micro ball head. This one right here. This is for the small diameter seats. Some of these multi-valve overhead cam cylinder heads, they'll put three valves, four valves, and there's some that have five valves out there. Audis, I think there's a BMW. I could be wrong on that. I believe there's a Honda out there with five valves in it. Got little bitty stems, little bitty seats, and of course we could grind those with the little bitty seat grinding stones that we offer. But once you get into the 3D fast cut system, you want to go ahead and use that best that you can. So the drive head is the same for it, but we allow you to get down close to that half inch seat. We change the tool tip holders. You can see these cutters are quite small as well. I don't know if that's coming through on the other side of that screen for you to really view, and I'll try to get some close-up insert shots for you to give a little more definition to this. But we do have a series of FTM prefixed cutter tips that are specifically designed to go with the micro ball head and the tooling. One thing you got to keep in mind, on a regular ball head like this right here that takes a 375 pilot, 385 pilot, 437 pilot, is that this now has to take, for us to get this down to this small diameter, the pilot got in our way. I couldn't get the finger and blade to get close enough to take care of those small diameter seats. It would only go in so far because the pilot was then in the way, even on the smallest tool tip holder. So we couldn't make that work. We came up with the micro head, and that made us also have to create a 6mm top pilot. Solid carbide, bloody expensive, I know, $200 a piece, 6mm on the top, and a variety of sizes specific to the guide dimensions on these small multi-valve overhead cam cylinder heads. On the other end of the scale, standard micro, we can get into the 3+ inch diameter seats. This is our wide body, or the L body that we have. You can see it's got quite a large tool tip holder on here. Still uses all the same tips you see up here on all these boards. This pocket here is like identical. So we can still use our same tips, but this gives us that increased diameter, mostly on your diesel, your high performance applications. We can still use our 375 pilot here, like we would in this standard ball head, or 385 or 437, whatever you're used to using. Some applications, you'll put a carbide pilot in the equation, because a high speed steel pilot can actually bend from the cutting pressure of that single point cutter doing all the machining three angles at the same time. So it kind of pushes that pilot around. Carbide will break before it bends. That's why we get the stability of the carbide, but it again comes at a higher price. So we can start you off standard, we can take you down small, and we can grow you into the large diameter valve seat applications that are out there. And that's where all this comes into play when you first get going on the 3D fast cut system from Guts and Tools and Supplies. We've also got to deal with a drive system. One thing that all the ball head manufacturers kept in mind, I'm really happy that they did, is this ball right here is a perfect 1-inch sphere. Surdy, Sonnen, Rottler, Quickway, Winona Van Norman, Comac, all the current machines that are out there right now. One thing they maintained was a 1-inch sphere. So if your machine already has a ball drive that came with it, you don't have to buy a different one. But if you don't have a ball drive And that's how this works. It goes together like that, and it actually drives the ball head. That's why we call it a ball head drive. We need to match this into your seat and guide machine. Early seat and guide machines had a number 3 Morris taper, which is what this is. The more beefy or heavy duty ones had a number 4 Morris taper on them. We've had a lot of customers that say, hey, I've got a really, tricked out, brand new, all digitized Bridgeport type mill. Does your 3D fast cut system work on that? The answer is yes, it does. We've had dozens and dozens of people using this toolkit on Bridgeport mills out there in the marketplace. I'm not scared of it at all, but we have to have a different drive. Those Bridgeports use a collet drive system. So this is our 3D 3/4 SS. We use the collet system right from the Bridgeport. It clamps onto here, and guess what? We're driving the ball head again. So number 3, number 4 taper, Bridgeport or collet drive, all designed to drive those ball heads. We also know that there are other machines out there, Surdy in particular, that wear the tools out. Now, Surdy took a different approach. They went directly into the quill of their machines. Where here, we had a ball drive and then we had a ball head. What Surdy, in its infinite wisdom, did, they decided to go directly into the quill of the machine. And then the finger and blade goes here, like it does. It's a 3/8 channel, like all the rest of them are. But this is, I believe, a number 30 taper. So we offer this as a replacement part for your Surdy machine, the 5100, or the larger one, the 5300. Again, the correct taper for your Surdy machine out there. Once we got all that done, we decided, well, what else can we do with this tooling? What else? I've already got this set up. I've got lots of dollars invested here. What else can I do as a machinist with the ball head? And we got to thinking, well, we know that there are fixed spring pad cutters. That's what this is right here. I call it the H. There's a specific dimension here, and that is designed with this pilot to be rotated, and it goes in and cleans up that spring pad, or you can use an oversized one to go to the next oversized spring when you're recamming a motor and putting the big double or even triple springs in there. You need to increase the dimension of that spring pad, and we offer these fixed cutters. We were the first ones to come out with an adjustable spring pad cutter. Now, this tool has been copied in the marketplace since we released it many years ago, but some of you are still not aware of it. Again, it works with the ball head, fits right into the channel. We can use our MGA MIC to, what's it do with my hands right here, to set our diameter. Most of the time on a spring pad, we're worried about, cutting into a portion of the cylinder head where we don't want to be, but you can set that with your MGA MIC mic. And of course, it sets up the same way. It's got a 3/8 square carbide tip here, and you can approach that dimension, taking a little bit and then do an adjustment and adjust it out until you get that spring pad to the specific diameter you're looking for. If the fixed spring pad cutters aren't dimensionally correct for the particular application you happen to be working on. Back in the day, we also used to have this thing called a bull hog. This was very, very popular in the 80s. Big, beefy piece of iron with solid carbide blades at specific angles. I think they were 70, 72, 75, 78, maybe even had some 81, 82 degree bull hogs, because the castings back in the 80s weren't as clean, for lack of a better description, as they are now. We're still feeding off of core piles, and you get in there to open up the underneath the valve seat in that bull area, there's some casting imperfections or deformities inside of there. This tool didn't really mind. It would get in there, hence its name, and hog it out. But these went by the wayside because the castings improved, and a lot of the cylinder heads you guys are getting now have most of that port work pre-done. Even the cast iron heads were that way. So we came up with a bowl profiling tool. Again, it's a finger to work right with the ball head itself. It slides right in there just like that adjustable spring pad cutter does. We set a different diameter, and again, these blades are available in different angles, so you can get into that bowl area and do a more of a finessing machine. You're kind of shaving with the tool at that point. You're not hogging by any stretch of the imagination. It's more of a finesse tool at that point. But again, it's running right off your ball head. So again, our whole concept was, what else can we do with the ball head now that we're all set up in that regard? We also looked at some of the other tooling systems that are out there. Myra comes to mind. It's a name that's been around for many, many years. Sonnen comes to mind. Name is of high quality that's been around for many, many years. Well, their initial tooling did not afford a replacement carbide blade. This was a brazed piece of carbide in here that had the different angles machined on it. It had to be resharpened. If it got broke, you had to rebraze the carbide on there or order a whole new assembly. So it really puts you in a precarious position because this tooling is becoming scarce to find in the marketplace. So again, we've made this finger and a blade, and we're at the right angle, right into your Sonnen ball head right here. And by the way, that has a perfect 1-inch sphere on it as well. We put this conversion finger in this ball head, and now I can use all these cutter blades right here, right into this conversion finger. Use all my pilots, all my original drive tooling, all everything else. And now I can enjoy all the variety of several hundred carbide cutters available. Hopefully you buy it from us, but they're available from many sources here in North America. So we made a conversion tool for the Sonnen ball head or the Myra tooling that was pretty standard, I think, on the KI and the Peterson seat and guide machines back there in the day. Most recently, we brought a product that wasn't brand new, but we had obsolete it because we figured all you engine builders had purchased them all by then. Well, I was wrong. Once in a while, yeah, Dave Monyhan will be wrong. And so I obsoleted our DWA 300, which is our adjustable counterbore kit. Now you got a quarter inch of range here, and because of the interference fits on a valve seat into an aluminum casting, which is 7 to 9 thousandths, versus a crush factor in a cast iron casting, which is 5 to 7 thousandths. The fixed carbide cutters that we all grew up with many years would maybe not have that interference correct. So it had to go to an adjustable. Also, some of the diesel applications have a 10, 20, or 30 over valve seat. And again, very difficult to line up specifically with a predetermined fixed size. And all the seat and guide machine companies put out, I think everyone got about a dozen of these cutters with the seat and guide machine, all fixed for a certain range. And they were all the same size across all the manufacturers because back in those days, nominal sizes were prevalent throughout the marketplace. Not so much today. Everything is different. Everything is metric. Everything is plus 10, plus 20. The crush factors are more apparent with the advent of all the aluminum applications that are out there. So we brought the DWA 300 or the adjustable seat counterbore set back. And you guys have been buying them. We thank you very much for that, of course. But now they are on the shelf and immediately available to you. So there's been a lot going on in the tooling world. And I'm very proud to offer you our 3D fast cut system, whether it be the standard ball head as you see here, the micro ball head for the multi-valve overhead cam cylinder heads, the large ball head for your go fast high performance applications or those big diesels that are out there, plus all the versatility of adjustable spring pad cutting, bowl profiling, and on, as you can see on this table, there's a lot going on. And that's what you expect from your shop supply company. Be innovative, be responsible to the marketplace, have the inventory on the shelf, have it at a reasonable price, and back it up with some of the best service you'll find in the marketplace. And that's what we do here at Goodson Tools and Supplies. You want to contact us, catch us on the web at goodson.com or call us direct, 1-800-533-8010. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.